갑자기 내게 나타나죠 너. 난 아무 말도 할 수가 없었지.
Hello my wonderful people, my beautiful people. If today is your first time watching my video, please don't forget to subscribe, like and share. Thank you so much for watching. God bless you. And today I will be talking about something very important in our lives. You know, as we came here, we got married, we have children, and we are married to different kind of people we don't even know, we don't even think that we will get married to. But that God's so kind, we are married and we have children. God bless us with beautiful children. And you know, in this country, many things, many situations, many cases where the government collect their children. Not really they want to collect the children. Sometimes those governments, they love to collect the children. I found out that those children they are really collecting, not that they are treating them well. They are not treating them well. The people they even give these children to, those people, they use these children to make a lot of money, because when they collect the children, the government pay a lot of money for that child that they are going to be taken care of. That is the most reason why those Jugendheim people, those people that take children from their parents, that is the main reason why they collect those children from them. Not that they take care of the children the way, you know, parents is parents. Parents will always take care of their children more than any other thing. But this country, they love collecting people's children because they don't like to give. They don't love to have their own. Some of them, they value dog, value cats, value any other animal more than children. They don't even want to go to that labor room where you labor, have these children of your own. They don't want to go there. That is the main reason why they try all their best just to collect another people's children, to take them to be like their own children, which is very bad, which is not a good thing. There is advice I'm going to give you women. Those people that are the most people that collect children from is those people that don't have anything doing. They are not working, and they see that opportunity to collect your children because they know that they are taking care of you. They are all your responsibility is on them. Please be careful when you have children. Try and brought your children up at home. Tell your children before they go out, make a law, a rule and a law in your house. Tell the children that anything that happen in your house, stay in the house. No matter what, whosoever is going to ask them, they should not say anything. This is what I brought my children up to do. You know, when there was when they are kids, like 6 months, 7 months, my pastor used to say that even babies, they listen to you, they hear you when you are speaking, they hear everything that you say. I started it when there was a baby. When I'm taking them to kindergarten, I used to tell them, when your teacher asks you what happened at home, don't say any word. Just tell, when the teacher said nothing happened, what happened in our house, stay in our house. It is our rule. It's our privacy. This is our privacy. We don't need to share our privacy outside. This is our own security. You understand? Try and brought your children in that way, that anything that happened in your house, stay in the house. And the more you are telling them every day, the more these things stay on them, the more these things stall on their head. But if you don't start it, there is no how they can be able to understand what you are meaning. Just for instance now, like my kids, something that was like 4, 5 to 6 years ago, when my daughter was still going to a kindergarten. Do you know what happened? The teacher, as I was taking her to school, she did something wrong. Then I quarreled with her, you know. Then she was crying. When she got to school, the teacher was asking, why are you crying? You know, she could not say anything, you know. Then the teacher said, why are you crying? She said, nothing. But you are crying, nothing. You are crying. Then the only word she can tell the teacher that anything that happened in our house, stay in our house. We are not allowed to say. Then the teacher now said, why? And I told the teacher that I brought them up like that. What happened in our house, remain in our house. They are not allowed to say it to a stranger, because you, teacher, are their stranger. They are not, you are not part of our family. You are just a teacher. Then the teacher looked at me, she smiled, said, wow, that is very good. That is the main reason what we can learn, we can do. This is the only thing we can do, because it's not easy to bring children up. Those people are always there to collect our children. They are always there to kidnap them, take them away from us. But with God, and you do your part and leave the rest for God, God Almighty will always help us to secure these children. This is the only advice I can tell you, mothers and fathers. Don't, you know, somehow, you know, my kids, somehow, my, you know, like we that are married to a German, you know, my husband does not know how to beat the kids or hit the kids. Even when she's angry with them, she will just talk to them. And the children, they don't take his word really serious because they know that he does not mean it. And these children, they look at the face. When you talk to them, make sure that when you take an action, stand by your action. Do it the way you need to do it, because these children, they'll always look. Sometimes they will ask me something, I will say no, they won't ask my husband, and my husband will say no, because anything my husband say, I stand upon it. Anything I say, my husband stand upon it, no matter what. Because if two people are having different mind and I say something, my husband says something, they will not. That means anytime they want something, either they come to me when I say yes, my husband say no, they will always want to, you know, it's like they are dividing us, which is not supposed to be. We are one family. It's not something to divide. They're not supposed to divide us because we are one family. Children, we should learn how to bring these children up. It's not easy. We need the grace of God. We need all the power. We need all the strength. We need the grace of God to bring these children up. Our children are the most treasured thing, the most important thing that we can do. Also, there is another thing I can be able to advise you guys. You know, some of our children here, because we can't speak the language, and they, in the school, they are not really doing well in the school, because you can't teach them. Because you can't, not that you don't want to teach them, but because you don't understand the language, there is no how you can. My sister, my brother, if you are not working, go to the government. They will give you a teacher that will come and be teaching the children extra in the house, so that your children can catch up with those ones in the school. There is opportunity, many opportunity in this country, many chances in this country, how you can live, how you can do with these children, how you can do everything. There is more chances. If your children does not have a place of doing sport, this country, they can provide a sport for them. They can be paying for it. If you are the type that is not working, you have more chances, like we that is working. People that are working have low chances. They do everything on their own. But people that is not working have more chance for the government to help them, for them to help them in many ways. There is disadvantage also. The disadvantage of it, if your children complain that you are doing them not well in the school, then you have more problem. They focus on those people that are not working. They want to collect their children because they believe that you are not working, you have the right to take care of your children very well, as you supposed to do. But those people that are working, they see that, oh, maybe you don't have time because you are working a lot and you are paying a lot of bill, and you don't give them that responsibility. But you that are not working, you are giving them all your responsibility. It's your duty for you to take care of your children very well, more than those people that are working. This is the only thing I can say. Guys, remain blessed. I will be coming up to say more about it. Okay? You guys should remain blessed, and God bless you all as you listen. Bye-bye.